Around that time, 56, 57, Stan's secretary called me up. She said, "Joe," she said, "I got some bad news." She said, "You know, we're having a little problem. The books aren't selling as well because the Korean War was over." That was a big seller, but the biggest loss was the horror books. Once the comic code came in, it killed the comic, the horror trend, and that was our big bread and butter seller in those days. And so anyway, she said, "Could you take a cut?" And I said, "Gee, I'll have to flow, you know." So anyway, they cut my rate, you know. And she said, "Joe, we're cutting everybody's rate." So maybe a month or so later, she called me up again. "Joe, we got to cut again." And by 1958, when we did go belly up, our rates were cut in half. In other words, from what we were getting originally, we were getting half, and yet expected to do the same kind of work, you know. So then I realized, you know, being a freelance comic artist was not all that it was cracked up to be, because we loved drawing and it's what we wanted to do, but it had its downsides, Mike, you know. And it was a shock, because holy, I never thought that they could cut your rate, you know. Yeah. But being naive, you know, that's what happens, you know. So it was a bad time, the late 50s. We had some great guys that dropped out of comics. Johnny Craig, he was one of the best. He worked for EC. And he did come over to Marvel when EC folded. And he worked for a while, but he went into advertising. And a couple of my friends dropped out of comics, never came back, you know.
Yeah. Well, that leads me.